the participle. So today we are going to discuss about the topic the participle. Chapter 23, page 161. So all of you open your English grammar textbook, page number 161. Chapter 23, the participle. So before discussing about the topic in details, let us see some examples. Example 1. The farmer was on his dying bed. Number 2. The faded flowers were thrown away. Number 3. You are playing a losing game. Number 4. Buddha took pity on the wounded swan. Number 5. Barking dogs seldom bite. Number 6. His broken leg was plastered. Here, the words that are in bold and underlined, that is dying, faded, losing, wounded, barking, broken. So these words are apparently verbs. So in the following examples, words like dying, losing, barking. So here, the word dying is formed from the first form of verb plus ing. That means the first form of verb here is die, and ing has been added to the word die, and then the word dying has been formed. Similarly, in the word losing, the first form of verb, that is lose, is there, and the word ing has been added to it in order to form the word losing. Again, in the word barking, the first form of verb, that is bark, plus ing, when ing is added to the first form of verb, that is bark, then the word barking is formed. Now let's see the words that are in example 2, 4 and 6. So the words are faded, wounded and broken. So all these three words, that is faded, wounded and broken, they are the third form of verb. That means they always end in D, ED, EN or N. So here the words dying, faded, losing, wounded, barking, broken, these words are participles. So now let us discuss and learn what is a participle. A participle is a word that is partly a verb and partly an adjective. So when we say a participle, the word which is there in a participle, it acts as partly a verb and partly as an adjective. So it means that the words or the participle has both the features of a verb as well as an adjective. So the verbs in the following examples behave as adjectives and are followed by nouns. So the examples like: the farmer was on his dying bed. So here the participle dying is acting as an adjective, and here bed is a noun. So here the word dying is followed by the noun bed. In example 2, the faded flowers were thrown away. The word faded here is a participle which is behaving like an adjective for the noun flowers. So here faded is the participle and flowers is the noun. In example 3, you are playing a losing game. Here, losing, which is also a verb, is acting or behaving like an adjective, and it is following the noun game. So here losing is acting partly as a verb and partly as an adjective. So it is a participle. Again, in the next example, that is, Buddha took pity on the wounded swan. So here the word wounded is acting partly as a verb and partly as an adjective, and it is also following the noun swan. So here wounded is also a participle. Example 5, barking dogs seldom bite. Here the word barking is acting again as partly as a verb and partly as an adjective, as it is telling us what the dog is doing. So here the word barking is also following the noun dogs. So barking is a participle. Example 6, his broken leg was plastered. So here the word broken is also again acting as partly as a verb and partly as an adjective, as it is telling us about the noun leg. That means the leg is broken. So here the word broken is also following the noun leg. So broken is a participle. So therefore the words that is dying, faded, losing, wounded, barking, broken, these are all acting as a verb as well as an adjective. Therefore, they are participles. And also, each of these words are following a noun. So, all these words that are bold and underlined, these are all participles. In each of the sentences, none of the verbs, they are acting as a pure verb, because all the verbs that we have seen in these examples, they are behaving both as an adjective as well as a verb. Therefore, they are known as participles. So, now all of you underline the definition given in your book, that is page number 161, which is given in a highlighted area. That is, a participle is a word that is partly a verb and partly an adjective. So, it is very important. So, underline the definition. Again, participles are also known as verbal adjectives. This is because each of the participle, they behave as an adjective as well as a verb. So, they are also known as verbal adjectives. So, now all of you underline the sentence. The verbs are all of them behave as adjectives and are followed by nouns. So, these words are called verbal adjectives or participles. These lines are given in the page 161 below the example portions. So, underline this two sentences. So, here we have come to know that a participle is a word which is partly a verb and partly an adjective. And each of these participles are followed by nouns. And also they behave as adjectives. And they are also known as verbal adjectives. That means participles are also known as verbal adjectives. Now, let us discuss the types of participles. So, there are two types of participles. The first one is known as the present participle and the second one is the past participle. First, let us see some examples. Example 1. I saw him stealing a ring. Example 2. Atul is a promising lad. So, in both these examples, the word that is stealing or promising are ending in ing, and each of them represents an action as going on or incomplete or imperfect. Here the words that is stealing and promising, the present participle of these words are formed when the verb that is the first form of verb that is steal and promise, and then ing is added to the word that is steal and promise, then the word becomes stealing and promising, and therefore they also become the present participle. So a present participle is formed when a verb that which is in its first form or in its base form is being added to ing, then it becomes a present participle. Now let us see some more examples. Example 1. His broken leg was plastered. Example 2. The stolen ornaments are with the thief. So in these two examples, the words that is broken and stolen are denoting an action or state that is completed and is no longer in progress. So they are known as past participle. So in a past participle, the verb is generally in its third form. That means in the past participle, the word usually ends in ed, d, t, en or n. This is very important. So in past participle, the words generally ends in ed, d, t, en or n. Like the words that is broken and stolen, they are ending in n. So they are past participle. So a third form of participle is known as past participle, and the past participle usually ends in the words that is ed, d, t, en or n. So now all of you underline that participles are of two types, as number one, a verb plus ing participle, which is called present participle, and number two, a third form participle, which is called past participle. It is there in page number 161 below. So underline this. So there are two types of participles that we have come to know. They are present participle and past participle. So students, in the next video, we are going to discuss the next topic, that is the gerund.